I'm Moon Ribas and I'm from Barcelona. And I wear a sensor attached to my arm that vibrates every time there's an earthquake anywhere in the planet. So I'm constantly connected to the seismic activity of the Earth. I've been feeling these earthquakes for the last 2 years, and now this has become a new sense for me, and I call it the seismic sense. I have three brothers and I grew up in a very traditional family Mediterranean setting. My parents treated me like different from my brothers and I could really feel that when I was a child. And I complained a lot about it. I had to do the beds, but my brothers didn't have to do. I had to help my mother in the kitchen, my brothers had to help my father. I had to always go to the market to pick up the bread. It's like, like little things that I couldn't understand why I had to do it and my brothers didn't have to. The dynamics in my house have changed a lot. Like, there's no these stereotypes anymore. They open up and I can see that they are happier because I feel that when there's all these traditions and when there's all these reduce of freedom, no one is actually winning, no one is really happy because they feel restricted. So I think they learn to realize that to be more free is not to be bad, to be more free is actually a positive feeling for everyone. So I think my family feels more free. I'm happy for that. I think I just feel a cyborg. I didn't decide to become a cyborg. It was part of a natural process. I had this need to grow up also in perceptions and senses. So I wanted to explore the world that I live in a different way and in a deeper way. I had this need to perceive a movement that it was universal, that it didn't depend on people or objects. And then I realized that the Earth is constantly moving through seismic activity and through earthquakes. So I found it that it would be fascinating to transform this huge movement to one body. And this is what I've been exploring for the last 2 years. And then this has become part of my identity and my body and part of me. So then I realized that I was a cyborg. Focus on what fulfills me, to unite myself with cybernetics is the union with nature and animals and also in my artistic world. And maybe this is what makes I feel that it's different from the other people who are in the technology world more. Maybe they're more technical or they think more about in a practical way, and I and with the Cyborg Foundation we think more about the art that can come out from this and your relation with the planet. I consider myself a feminist because I believe that women and men need the same rights. It's something that I always thought, and I didn't realize that I was a feminist, obviously. I want a world where everyone is equal. I think if women were more into technology, maybe the feelings that I had that it was cold and distant, and women could help in giving another point of view to this connection to the human and technology. I would like to encourage people, not just women or just men, just like in general, to experiment with their perceptions and senses, to find their own sense and their own perception of the world, because I'm sure everyone could be able to perceive constantly the Earth moving. Probably cities wouldn't be built in those places where they are built, and probably our living would change. So I think if we would understand better what the planet needs, our way of living would change.
2016.
Yeah, I'm shy, and usually I hide behind Neil, which is my best friend from childhood and my the co-founder of the Cyborg Foundation. I prefer him to talk always. So I think I would like to change that and be able to have my own voice and talk also and spread our thoughts and our philosophy and encourage other people in my own words.
25 years and my life is still trying to get up that great big hill of hope.